Good evening, everyone. Jewel here with you with a tropical update, but this is kind of a different tropical update. We're going to check on conditions around. First, we're going to start with rivers and flooding. You know, Miss Idalia is going to make an appearance at my house, so I've been trying to prepare all day. Don't worry about me. Everything will be okay. You know why. Jesus is on my side, and when it gets to my house, it's just going to be like tropical storm stuff. But what gets me is after the eye of the storm passes us, the wind is still going to push water up into the rivers and the sounds, and that's going to just make the water build up, and that's going to be a big problem for me. But let's check on our friends down in Florida. Let's see what's happening right around here. You can see the river, it comes up in here, and they are just about in this area of major flooding. Not quite, but almost. As we move down some more, let's get over here, see what's going on. This is the Gulf of Mexico tide gauge at Crystal River. They got flooding going on from the river like crazy. What's going on over here? This is also a tidal gauge from Crystal River, you can see. Once it gets in that purple, it's flooding, folks. It's flooding, it's flooding. It's flooding before that, but it's not as bad. Once it gets into the orange and the purple, look out, it's going to be flooding. We'll come down here right quick. This doesn't look too bad. No, they're in minor flooding right now. As we move on down, let's see what's happening here. They're just beginning to flood some right there. Now, let's come back up here just a moment. I want to see if I can make this map a tiny bit bigger, so I can get some more of these areas right in here. Flooding. Flooding. See, there's four gauges here. We didn't go over all flooding. Flooding. Everybody in this area right here, you got river flooding like crazy. That's not talking about the storm surge or all the rain you had or this, that, and the other. This is just the rivers right now down in these areas here. And by the way, I want to thank Zen, one of our subscribers down in Florida around the Tampa area, I believe, for telling me how bad places had flooded there around her area. Thank you very much. Now, the storm is moving, as we all know. So, we're going to move up some now. We're going to get up into Georgia. Let's make this a little bit smaller for the moment. You can see all the places in Florida. Everybody in the green, you're looking okay for the most part. Now, let's make this a little bit bigger so we can see what we're doing here. Let's see. I think Waycross, you're okay. Come on and load up. There we go. Yeah, you're not doing anything much. It's just beginning to get a little bit high for you. As we move on through, checking everybody out. I know this takes a little bit of time, but it's worth it. It's worth it, my friends. You need to know what's happening. Let me make this map smaller so I can get a bigger range going on. Okay, here we go, Valdala. This is what I want to get in right in here. Make sure I've got all the gauges in. I'll make it a little bigger. Over in this area right here, let's see what's going on. This is around near Mount Vernon. No flooding going on. And this is around Highway 280 near Mount Vernon. That river's doing okay right now. We'll come down here. This is near Reidsville. You guys almost had some major flooding going on, but it looks like it started to level out now. This is near Reidsville, Georgia. The water's still high. didn't make it to major flooding almost, but now it looks like it's leveled out, and it is flooding some at this point. We'll come down here right quick. This is close to Blacksey, Georgia. You're in some minor flooding stages right now. So we move on across. Savannah. Let's check out Savannah. See what it's looking like. It's just up and down. This is from the lab. Okay, we're going to come down here right close. This is the Savannah River, and it can't make its mind up, but it doesn't look like it's flooding really that bad yet, but it looks like it could before all is said and done. So please pay attention to this. And we will check out Beaufort, South Carolina. That's out in the ocean. It's going up and down like crazy. We're going to move over here. Let's check on Charleston. You've had some major flooding today. Looking like it's flooding right now. This is the gauge at Cooper River at Charleston Harbor in South Carolina. You do have some major flooding going on right now in areas of this river. It will go back down, but looks like probably by Friday morning early and Thursday, it's going to start to rise again, as you can see, getting up to the moderate flooding. That's the thing about this storm, folks, especially for the people along the Carolinas. The wind and the rain we can handle, even maybe the storm surge to some degree. But this isn't moving like most storms we have. It's not moving from south to north. When that happens, we have all the water come in, but then in an hour or so, the storm pulls the water back out. Well, that's not the case here. This is going to be coming in, moving from west to east. And even after the storm is over, the wind is still going to push water up into the oceans, up into the sounds, up into the rivers, the creeks, and everything like that. So please remember that and be aware of it, okay? We'll see what North Charleston is looking like. This is Cooper River at North Charleston. It's just going up and down, just like the main one had a while ago. So you guys are just going to have to keep your eyes on this, okay? We'll check right here. Santee River in Jamestown, South Carolina. You've had a little bit of flooding going on. Not real bad today. Looks like it's going back down, but it will rise, okay? Now, as the tides progress, we all know we got the king tides going on along with the blue moon action going on and the super moon and all that. As you can see on this graph, looking like by 3 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, you're going to have some flooding. It won't be major. This has just got to action. It may get to minor, but it doesn't look like it's going to get to major by 3 p.m. tomorrow afternoon. So if you live close to this river in that area, you be aware of it. Myrtle Beach. Let's see what's going to be happening there. Oh my goodness, look at this. Already today, they have had some minor flooding. Looking like 3 p.m. today. And it's a little after 3 right now. You're going to be almost to moderate flooding, and it's going to stay that way through Saturday, up and down, flooding's going to be going on, so be aware. Let's check another place in Myrtle Beach. This is the Atlantic Intercoastal Waterway. You can see for the regular waterway itself right now, it is down some, but it's going to keep piling up, just trust me. Now, when we get up to North Carolina, let's see what's going to be going on here. We're all pretty good right now, for the most part, I think. We'll check right here, the Atlantic coast. This is the Johnny Mercer Pier at Wrightsville Beach. Already today, this afternoon, they've had a little bit of minor flooding going on. and that looks like it's going to continue. It will go down, but it's going to come back up all the way until at least, I'd say, Friday afternoon. And we'll check one more at Cape Fear. Looking like the same thing going on. It almost got to moderate flooding, but it's been minor flooding so far. Now we'll get up here in my neck of the woods. Let's check out just a little south of me, down around Jacksonville. This is Queen Creek near Herbert, North Carolina. You're looking pretty good right now. We're all looking pretty good right now. This is the New River, Jacksonville, when it pops up here. Everybody's looking good. That's because the storm hadn't got to us yet, okay? I guarantee you by tomorrow this time, we will see some water in places. Let's check out Newbern here along the Trent River. Still looking good, still looking good. And we're going to go to Kinston. I know my friend Mary lives in Kinston, and this is the Neuse River at Kinston. Looking very good, Mary. You're looking okay. You should be A-okay, all right? Now, when we get up here, let's check out and see what mine's looking like. The Pamlico River, as it pops up here, I'm still good. Look, when I had Florence, I was way up there in the purple. I don't think I'll get to that now, but I think it is going to get up the orange and the red. Yes, I have flooding. So, anybody who has one of these gauges, if you want to keep up with me, this is the way to do it. And I just wanted to bring this to everybody's attention. We will check out Greenville, the Tara River. It should be okay right now, too. It is. Everything looking okay right now. But all of this is going to change, so please be aware and stay safe. Okay, we're over here at the Euro model. This is strictly just the Euro model, but it's been pretty good. And hey, I want to say thank you to everybody who has been so kind to me, giving me such kind words about how I forecast a storm. I appreciate that very, very much, and I thank everybody that watches my videos and shares them, and thank you so much for the donations you sent me through YouTube or PayPal. I appreciate that very, very, very much. Now, here we are. Okay, right now you can see 2 p.m. Well, that's 2 p.m., but this is where the storm was at that time. The wind, the storm right now are 75 miles per hour. Track through a little bit and see what it looks like. As time is on, you can see how the storm's moving right along. Let's cut it off for a second and check something. Looking like around 4 p.m. this afternoon, right in between Hinesville and Baxley, right up in here. We'll turn it on and let it run some more. You can see a timestamp down at bottom, 5 p.m. Nudges a little bit to the east, but not a whole heck of a lot, huh? Staying mostly on this track. As it gets up around, it should be, save. It says here, probably about 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock. Now, this time it wrote in stone, you know it can change. But then it really takes off. Look at that. Look how it's traveling now. 8 o'clock around Beaufort. Then it's coming up towards Charleston. It's gonna fully encircle Charleston. So, like I was showing you those river maps a while ago, if you live in Charleston, get right, because you probably are going to have some type of flooding with this storm. This is around 11 p.m. tonight as it starts to move through Charleston, the Charleston area. Anybody in these areas, you're going to know it's around. You don't just have to be in Charleston. You don't just have to go by this one particular, because we all know how these storms go. And I'm going to keep moving down. You can pull the little tropical storm itself right here. And what gets me, this storm just don't want to die. Even when it is a tropical storm, now it's coming off the coast of Georgetown, getting close to Southport, Myrtle Beach, all these areas going to know what's around. Look, still 63 mile per hour winds at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. Isn't that something? And those winds are going to remain that way even out in the ocean, and that's what's going to keep pushing the water back towards this way. So if you live in a coastal community, be aware of this. Be aware of this and stay safe. Now, for my neck of the woods, eastern North Carolina, this is for Washington, Aurora, Plumas, all these areas in here, okay? Especially along the river banks. Plumas, be aware. Confidence is high that the event will occur. Confidence is high regarding the impact. Significant impacts from flash flooding possible of 3 to 8 inches of rain. That's just the rain. And I've looked up exactly where I live, looking like in 2 hours I'm going to get almost 4 inches of rain. And it's going to rain all night and all day tomorrow. So we're going to get some rain, folks. Now, we do have a chance of a few tornadoes possible, especially a little south, say, in Craven and Carteret County. And we could have some here in Beaufort County, so be aware of that. Now, if you live in a low-lying area, especially adjacent to the southern Pamlico Sound, including the Neuse, Bay, Pamlico, and Pungo Rivers, be aware. I've got my truck moved to a higher ground area now. I'm not going to take a chance. Tropical storm force winds, possibly especially toward the coast of the Outer Banks. And listen, Ocracoke, be aware. You're going to get this, and you're going to get it pretty significant at one point. Please stay safe. Dangerous marine conditions expected across the coastal waters. The conditions that we can have around my house will probably wash up some pier boards, maybe some marina damage, things like that. Hopefully my house will be safe. It probably will get up to my door, but I hope it doesn't come in. But this is what it's looking like for eastern North Carolina. Watches and warnings are posted over on the community page. Everyone should know what's going on in your area by now. Here's a look at what is happening. Idalia, 75 mile per hour winds. Pressure 981 millibars. Located 31.4 north, 82.5 west. Moving at 20 miles per hour. So once the rain starts where you are, it's going to blow on through. It'll last maybe 12 hours and be out of your hair. It's fast moving. Let's hope and pray once she gets right about here, she don't start to strengthen again. Now, we have Franklin. His winds have come down drastically from what they have been. They're 105 miles per hour now. Pressure 961 millibars. Located 33.9 north, 66.6 west. It is moving northeast at 13. 11. Disturbance number 2. It's not 11. It's disturbance number 2 here. I don't think it's going to do a whole lot. It's just the remnants of GERT. I'm not really worried about it bothering anyone right now. Here is Tropical Depression 11. The winds are 35 miles per hour with a barometric pressure of 1,014 millibars, located 28.3 north, 52.1 west. It is moving directly north. It shouldn't bother anybody at the moment at 2 miles per hour. Now, we finally got off the coast of Africa that we talked about all week long, getting off the coast. We finally are off there, and it is a tropical wave, and it is still near the Cabo Verde Islands with disorganized showers and thunderstorms. Environmental conditions do appear conducive for this system to have some gradual development, and a tropical depression is likely to form later this week while the system moves west-northwest to northwestward across the eastern tropical Atlantic. Now it's moving on up. 2 days 50%, 7 days 60%. Everyone, I am going to watch it like a hawk. And that's what's going on and what things are looking like right now. I may not be able to be with you in the morning. It all depends on if I have electricity and internet. So take care of yourselves. God bless you all. Thank you for watching. Share this information, please, with your family, your friends, and on your social media to help me keep people aware of what might be coming their way. Thank you for the donations you send me through PayPal or here on YouTube. I couldn't make it without you, folks. And, you know, preparing's one thing, but when you're in a wheelchair preparing, that's something else. And I really appreciate you guys for doing what you do for me very, very, very much. God bless everybody. Please stay safe. Two people I know have died down in Florida from the storm surge flooding, and I have had one person off my coast die in a rip current. Why are you folks doing this? The rip currents are awful up and down the entire eastern seaboard coast. Don't go in the water. That's all I got to say. And please, if you start to flood somewhere, don't drive through it. Don't even do something like that. Turn around. Find another safe place to get. I love you guys. God bless you all. Thank you for watching.